Okay, so I'm going to start with this picture here, what I see. You can see how the modern tree all have these points here. And these points, here you see it on a horse that's dissected, sit behind the shoulder blade. The reason why all saddles have these saddle tree points is it needs to stop the saddle from sliding over the neck without damaging the shoulder or without interfering the ability to move underneath. So that's why it's important that the bars of the tree adapt properly, so when the back comes up, it releases the pressure in the front. So now we talk about girth. When I look at, let me switch my PowerPoint for that. When I look at the shape of the girth, it's very important to understand. If you look from the bottom of the horse here, you see the sternum and you see the elbow. Because horses have no collarbone, it is very often that the distance from the sternum plate to the left elbow, the distance from the sternum plate to the right elbow is not the same. Very easy, you can check it. You put the saddle behind the shoulder, you look your billets, do they hang perpendicular? On the right side, they might. Then you go to the other side. Oh my God, I got to jerk the billets forward. And then you say, oh, my saddle is crooked. You hang it on the back of the chair. The saddle is absolutely straight. It's not twisted. The billets are absolutely symmetric. Put it back on the horse, but they don't line up. See, we want to think in our head that the horses are all 100% symmetric. Of course they're not. They're just as symmetric as you are. We have different faces and all our organs are in different places. Okay? We even weigh different on the left versus the right leg. So why do you think your horse is symmetric? So if we talk about the girth, it is absolutely important that the shape, the length, and where it's positioned is being considered. So some girths have the shape, I think the question was, how does the shape of the girth affect saddle fit? So some say we make it very wide here, and then we go back this way. Look at the shape of the rib cage. They're wide here and they go narrow. So just as much on top, on the bottom, gravity rules. The girth will always go through the narrow spot. It looks for that elbow. So if you have a girth and it comes up here and then it curves back this way and goes up, all the pressure, and some of these shaped girths put so much pressure behind the sternum plate. All of you guys know when you want to lift the horse's back, you either push on the sternum plate or in the solar plexus, and the horse will either cow kick you or will bring the back up. The pressure on that back sternum plate is sometimes so intense on those shaped girths, and then the front of the girth in this area, it just hangs down like a tongue out of a dog when the dog run a lot of miles. Okay, you wonder, why is that even shaped to the front when there's absolutely no pressure on the front of the girth? So some shaped girths are so poorly designed that only where that pink bar is, that only 1 inch of the entire pressure of the girth instead of distributed over 8 inches. So instead of looking so much for girth, what is super shaped, you want one just as simple as they always done, a nice diamond shaped girth, nice and wide, 6 to 8 inches, and then narrow on the elbow. And then what you want is the saddle. Many companies have the ability, you can position these billets so they hang out in different areas. Your Colonel McClellan in 1857 designed a saddle so the soldier can move the billets forward on one side or the other side or both sides, so you don't need a shaped girth. So there's many saddles where can design the billets, because if they don't hang like this, if you have to do this and you think your shaped girth will help you, no. The shaped girth will only severely cuts in here. Super important is, like I just mentioned, it should be distributed even, and it should be away from this muscle here. That's the pectoralis muscle. Let me see if I find a better picture for you. That pectoralis muscle, the chest muscle. All right, so I'm gonna bring this up a little bit. Right through here, that is part of the muscle what holds the entire rib cage off the front limb, right? The pectoralis muscle is a super important muscle. So if your girth, many short girths are too short. They clear the buckle, the elbow, but the buckle is right on the edge. Do you like a buckle, or you like somebody poking you underneath your armpit, right on the edge of your pectoralis? I guarantee you don't like it. So make sure that above the elbow, a minimum of 12 inches, 10 to 12 inches, the buckle is. So the length is important, and the even distribution of the sternum is important. Stay away from the shaped girth, what go back, because when they're trying to sell you a shoulder relief girth, and the girth is here and the shoulder is up there, it never works. It always goes to the same problem. It drives the saddle in the cartilage. So that's my 2 cents on shaped girth.